Well, shalom, shalom. I'm Barbara, and I'm always short and sweet. And did you know the halo represents the sun, and it's not holy as thought by some? Today, I'm going to tell you the one thing that you need to know about the solar halo. It is a representation of sun worship. It's called a nimbus in art, a radiant circle or disc around the head of a holy person that represents a spiritual character, a symbolism of light. And because of its pagan origin, it was not seen in early Christian art. But you will see it in sacred art of ancient Greece, ancient Rome, Hinduism, Buddhism, Islam, and Christianity, among other religions. You will see that halo all the way back to paganism. So the solar halo, of course, was in Egypt and other ancient cultures, and it is a very ancient symbol, especially in Egypt. But if you want to know more about the sun god worship that began in Babylon, please look at my other YouTube videos, and I'll leave these links below at the very end. So here is the sun god of Egypt, Ra, crowned with a sun disk. Who is Ra? Well, he was the sun god of the world. They said he was the creator of the world, and he represented every god. But we know that is not true. But there's where a lot of this halo originated from. In the ancient pagan sun worship was in Greek mythology around Helios riding a chariot. The Nordic god was pulling a chariot with a sun disk. The Greek gods, Apollo, with sun rays. Greek god Neptune with a solar disk around his head. And the halo is also found in Buddhism, and it appeared in the third century, believed to be brought back from the Greek invaders. So here's Surya, a Sanskrit word that means the sun, and it means the solar deity of Hinduism. And here she is, drawn by a horse-drawn chariot by the sun and the horses. Roman mythology, Sol Invictus, depicted riding on a horse-drawn chariot here on the back of a coin and with the sun disk on the head of the coin. Rome had a god. It was Sol, the sun god, Sol Invictus. And halo was inherited by Christianity from ancient Egyptians who worshipped the sun. You didn't see the halo before the 4th century. There's where it first appeared with pictures of Christ. Then the 5th century, angels had halos. 6th century, Virgin Mary. And remember, in 321 AD is when Constantine joined paganism with the church. And that's when the solar symbol, the halo, started to appear on images and pictures. Now that you know halos represent the sun, did you know that sun worship is forbidden in the scriptures? Deuteronomy 4:19. Unless thou lift up thine eyes unto heaven, and when thou seest the sun and the moon and the stars, even all the hosts of heaven, and should be driven to worship them and serve them. And it would not be good, because the punishment was death if you served these other gods. They would be stoned. It was in Deuteronomy 17:3. So Hosea 4:6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge and worship. The definition for that is reverent honor and homage paid to God or a sacred personage or any object regarded as sacred. Remember Revelation 14:9, the third angel's message, if any man worship the beast in his image or receive his mark, that they would receive the wrath of God. So look for links below and like if this was a blessing to you, and please share with your friends and your family so they will know these things that are surrounding us in all of Christianity and other religions have these halos. And Revelation 18:4, come out of her, my people. That means we are in the middle of Babylon. We need to come out. So subscribe for more information and symbols. Hit that little bell there and subscribe so that you don't miss anything. Remember, I'm short and sweet, and I'll see you back again next week. Yahovah willing.